Today in America, the government is the servant of the corporations. The government of the people and by the people is purely a utopian concept, unrelated to reality. What we have in actuality is a government of the corporations and by the corporations. Let's consider the real state of the union, or should we say disunion. Recent events shows that when it comes to protecting our wealthiest companies, the government will do just about anything. As demonstrated with the bailouts, the laws and ethics of free enterprise were dismissed in order to protect corporate America. Fannie Mae alone received $88 billion in bailout funds, AIG $68 billion, General Motors 51, Bank of America 45, Citigroup 45 billion, JP Morgan Chase 25 billion, Wells Fargo 25 billion. And the list of 938 recipients reaches a grand total of 615 billion 944 million $506,423. But when the workers and citizens struggle to put food on the table, to keep their homes out of foreclosure, to secure adequate paying jobs, and to procure affordable health care, the government of the corporations objects to finding workable solutions. In fact, the most devoted servants of the corporations are the politicians. Deceptively, they blame the unions, illegal aliens, big government, and the poor for the nation's financial dilemma. When the American economy was on the brink of collapse, government leaders chose to neglect holding the corporate leaders accountable for their indiscretions and illegal practices. No provisions were instituted to compensate the taxpayers for bailing out these companies. When the taxpayers' money was used to bail out these failing companies, some people cried out, "Why, that's socialism!" This was not even true. The taxpayers received nothing for rescuing these companies. In a socialistic system, the public shares in the common ownership, reaping the benefits of profit as well as shouldering its losses. What kind of system uses the public's money to replace the losses of private industry without any reasonable form of compensation? It certainly is not capitalism or socialism. What we have today is an elite group of corporate leaders who dictate to the government and to the public the costs of doing business. This is not free enterprise. Corporate imperialism is something much worse than socialism. The long arm of corporate imperialism reaches into the pockets of our government through their lobbyists on K Street. The individual voter must take a back seat to the imperial interests of the corporations. For it is the lobbyists' money that pays the politicians' campaigns and shapes policy. Silently, Congress has stood by watching the chief executive officers of bailed-out companies receive exorbitant severance packages as they float away in their golden parachutes. How can one justify rewarding these leaders who have led their companies and their nation into financial ruin? However, to provide a reasonable cost of living adjustment for minimum wage workers, or the elderly, or the injured veteran, or the disabled receiving Social Security, the trusted servants of the government do nothing but boast about their sudden devotion to fiscal responsibility. How many Americans can fill up their gas tanks and afford to buy tomatoes? An honest answer to that question would reflect the true picture of the State of the Union. The average American is struggling to meet their basic needs while the leaders of industry become richer regardless of productivity. After the banks and speculators exploited this nation and circumvented the regulatory laws, the economy crashed. Unprincipled politicians and corporate greed took our nation into a depression. Trickle-down economics has left a shrinking oasis for a few in a vast wasteland of have-nots. At the end of the Bush administration, many large companies woke up with a terrible hangover. However, Congress used C-SPAN to showcase slapping them on the wrists, while they rewarded them with huge bailout sums. Publicly flogging these greedy executives was simply a show. Did they really think it would appease the American workers who have lost good jobs, their life savings, pensions, and their homes? Presidents Bush and Obama gave away billions to bail out the least deserving leaders in industry. The Tea Party of today is a front organization backed by corporate thugs intent on destroying health care reform, Social Security, and the universal rights that union workers fought and died for since the 1920s. If Americans fail to fight back soon, the middle class and poor will become a slave class run by plantation owners. And that's my take. This is Spadecaller.